There's been a lot of changes in the past 6 months. So I joined about 6 months ago and have been really driving a lot more focus inside the company because I think we have a huge opportunity to be growing faster. And so the story chronicled some of that. What we're really excited about is even in the past 6 months, we've driven a lot of really positive change in the company. We are growing faster. We accelerated our gross merchandise sales quarter over quarter. We accelerated revenue by more than 21%. In Q3, and we had our highest ever EBITDA margins.
The last time I went on, I noticed it was easier. I forget what you all did. Was it keeping my credit card information on hand or something? It was easier for me to go through and purchase a lot of things.
Thanks for noticing that. Yeah. So we've been improving the buying experience in many ways. We've improved the search engine. So we announced that the improvements we've made just in the past 6 months to the search engine, we expect will generate more than $100 million of additional sales. We make it more clear that we don't share your credit card information with the sellers.
With the vendors,
we've done a lot to really streamline the buying.
How much of it has been on the customer side, the customer-facing side? How much has it been on the supplier side?
So, you know, the great thing about a marketplace is that you work both sides. For example, we gave our sellers a tool that allows them to put items on sale. And now we're running our first ever Cyber Week sale. We ran our first sale ever over Labor Day, and the results were terrific. Not only did we dramatically increase sales for sellers who put their items on sale, but we also increased sales for sellers who didn't. So the opportunity to run sales and promotions has been something we've given to our sellers, which is really delivering for buyers and then delivering for
your business. Christmas season has usually ended sort of mid-December historically. Is that going to change, or is that a function of the fact that so much of the stuff is custom crafted things that people can't get later?
So first, it's true that Etsy is the place to go when you want to buy something special, something that's custom, personalized, made just for you, or expresses your sense of style. But there are many items that are available to ship right away, and so we've really increased the transparency of shipping on the site, so it's clear.
I would say that's been my one sticking point in the past, is sometimes I order something thinking 2.5 weeks is going to be enough time for it to get there, and it's not.
And there are actually items that can be delivered in just 3 or 4 days.
Yeah.
So we're really highlighting those items as we get closer to Christmas. We've also given our sellers the ability to gift wrap items and send them directly to the recipient. That's also, we hope, going to extend the shopping season for Etsy.
Right. Josh, talk about the macro environment. How much has handmade at Amazon impacted you? Obviously, everyone watches Amazon. We've been talking about Amazon a lot this morning. When they launched a few years ago, did that have a small or medium or big impact on your business?
You know, Amazon does a great job with convenience and selection, and so the place you go kind of every day again and again, but when you want it to feel special, there's no place like Etsy. And if you look at the traditional levers of retail, it's convenience, selection, and price. Amazon or other big mass retailers get a price advantage by buying in mass quantities, 100,000 units of an item. Well, if you can buy 100,000 units of something, it doesn't belong on Etsy. Convenience they get by warehousing things in advance and then shipping. Many of our items are customized, personalized. They're simply not things you can warehouse in advance. And in terms of selection, we have 1.9 million sellers with over 45 million items. We have at least one order of magnitude more selection than anyone else. So the traditional advantages that a mass retailer have simply don't translate to our space.
Do you know the sellers aren't selling in Amazon today for the most part?
You know, many of our top sellers say that they are multi-channel, but the vast majority of our top sellers say that the majority of their sales come from Etsy and that they expect that going forward, the majority of their sales will continue to come from Etsy.
Dana, what do you got there? Is this there's like a cat theme going on here?
Not a cat theme, but one of the biggest trends this holiday season is showing the love to your pampered pet, whether it's your kitty or your pooch. These items are actually completely customized. So this is by Shannon Broder. What you're going to do is you're going to send a photo of your favorite of your pet to Shannon. She is then going to screen put it on a pillow, and you will be able to display that on your couch or wherever. It's a great gift for yourself or for someone else.
I'm going to get this for Joseph and his dogs. What do you think about that?
This is a big operation day for. I'm sad. My dog. We've got some things going on. But thank you. I need to get her something. In fact, for maybe a get well.
You can do that, or you can get a custom illustration done. So with this seller, you send an image of your pet, and then they hand draw this
really
piece of art.
I don't really think that's a dog. Is that? That's not really a dog.
This is a Chihuahua.
I'm talking about a German Shepherd. I'm talking about
they
a German Shepherd.
They can do that too.
That could be breakfast for. No, I'm kidding.
Well, you know, and in terms of the shipping, the really wonderful thing about shopping with Etsy sellers is the fact that you have the opportunity to have that open dialogue because you're working with a person. So talk about when it is that you need to receive it, and it's all about just starting the conversation.
What do you got? What's that? What's in the circle?
So when this is a bag, this is a little
canteen.
Yeah, it looks like a canteen.
But it's a purse. But one of the major trends this year is all about treating yourself as well. So add yourself to that gift list and treat yourself to a handbag or a personalized candle. Another major trend is showing your home state some hometown pride and some love. Keep that place very special to your heart. So you can get in a candle or artwork or
whatever. Josh, what's the coolest thing you've bought since you've been running this company?
I bought a backpack for my daughter to send her back to school to show her that I love her and care about her, and a good way to show I'm thinking about her. You know, it's a great example that special can happen at any time during the year, not just Christmas.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.